This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A character class is a fundamental part of the identity and nature of characters in the dungeons. 22 Dungeons. Principal base classes. These classes have appeared as character classes in the core books of multiple published editions: Barbarian, Bard, Cleric, Druid, Fighter, Magic User, Mage, Wizard, Monk, Mystic, Paladin, Ranger, Sorcerer, Thief, Rogue, Warlock. Alternative base classes. See also, List of alternative dungeons. Advanced Dungeons. In 1st and 2nd editions, changing a character's class was difficult. Only humans could do it, and they had to meet some rather steep requirements to do so. This was called dual classing. Non-humans, on the other hand, could multi-class, where they effectively learned two or rarely even three classes at the same time at the cost of a slower character level progression. 3rd edition allowed players to mix and match levels from any number of classes, though certain combinations were more effective than others. In addition, prestige classes added yet more options for multi-class. This edition offers the most freedom regarding multi-classing. There are, however, penalties to the rate of experience point gained if classes are added haphazardly. The 3rd edition version of Unearthed Arcana includes rules for gestalt characters which combine the advantages of two classes. 4th edition allows characters to take a feat that gives a character access to specific facets of another class. The class-specific multi-class feats are also prerequisites for the power swap feats, each of which allows the character to swap out a daily, encounter, or utility power from their first class for one from their second class. Also, at 11th level, a character with a multiclass feat and all of the power swap feats is eligible for Paragon multiclassing, which allows a character to gain additional powers from their second class in lieu of taking a Paragon path. Some classes are only available through multiclassing. The first such class was Spellscarred, introduced in the Forgotten Realms Player's Guide in 4th edition. Each character can only multiclass into a single class, unless otherwise stated by their primary class, such as the Bard. The Player's Handbook 3 introduced hybrid classes, a deeper form of multiclassing in which elements of two classes are combined each level in 5th edition. Multiclassing requires a certain level of ability scores before a player can choose to do it, much simpler than 2nd edition's dual classing mechanic, as all of the core classes only require a 13 in the necessary stat, and apart from the Monk, Paladin and Ranger who need 13s in two stats, and the fighter requires either strength or dex, the classes only need one sufficiently high stat. Classes by Editions. Main article, Editions of Dungeons. Man and Magic User classes, all three non-human races had limited level advancement. Advanced Dungeons. Although non-human races often had restricted choices among classes and maximum levels they could reach in a class, the 5 standard base classes, 5 sub-classes in the Player's Handbook are listed in the adjacent table. The Player's Handbook also introduced the Bard as a 6th base class. However, its usage in 1st edition was more akin to what would be called a prestige class in later editions, as it was not a legal choice for a starting character. Instead, a character had to start as a fighter, change classes to a thief, and finally switch classes once more to become a bard. A character's ability scores directly tied into what class choices were legal for them. For instance, a character wishing to be a fighter required at least 9 strength, the more discriminating monk required 15 strength, 15 wisdom, 15 dexterity, and 11 constitution. Additionally, certain unusually high or low ability scores could proscribe class choice further. Too high an intelligence could disallow being a fighter, while a charisma of 5 or less would require the character to become an assassin. High ability scores in statistics considered pertinent to the class would grant an experience bonus. The Player's Handbook brought about other changes in the game and its character classes. Fighters, clerics, and thieves have improved hit dice D10, D8, and D6 respectively over the previous edition. The effects of a character's strength score on hit probability, damage, weight allowed, and open doors rolls were changed. High intelligence conferred an increased chance for both spell knowledge and ability to learn languages. The wisdom score now gave clerics a spell bonus, while low wisdom gave a chance of spell failure. New charts delineated the effects of constitution, dexterity, and charisma. Each of the 5 main character classes and 5 sub-classes had its own experience table. For most classes, it was now harder to gain promotion above 3rd or 4th levels. Multi-classed characters were also introduced. Dungeons. series included many optional classes for humans and non-humans, including the Shaman GAZ-12 and Shamani GAZ-14. Additional human and race classes were also presented in other supplements: second edition group class Warrior, Fighter, Paladin, Ranger, Wizard, Mage, Specialist, Wizard, Priest, Cleric, Druid, Priest of Specific Mythos, Rogue, Thief, Bard. The second edition of Advanced Dungeons Illusionist class from 1st edition became a type of specialist wizard. Specialists gained the ability to cast extra spells of their chosen school of magic in exchange for the inability to cast spells of opposed schools. A transmuter, for example, would gain extra spells per day in the school of alteration, but would be denied access to the schools of abjuration and necromancy. A similar distinction was made for priests. 2nd edition introduced priests of a specific mythology who would gain their own specific abilities, restrictions, and sphere of influence. Selection. The druid was provided as an example. The specification of other specialty priests was left to dungeon masters and setting books as an example. A specialty priest of Tempest, the god of war in the Forgotten Realms campaign setting, can incite a berserker rage in allies and lacks the only blunt weapons restriction of normal clerics. The selection of spheres of influence worked similarly to the allowed and forbidden schools of magic. The bard class, previously attainable only after switching from fighter, to thief, and lastly to bard, was changed to be a normal class that could be chosen at character creation. The assassin and monk classes were removed from 2nd edition, though the concept of a bare-handed fighter or a killer for hire certainly remained legal, just not as a class. The Dungeon Master's Guide clarified the rationale behind the decision in a section on creating new character classes. What is a Viking but a fighter with a certain outlook on life and warfare? A witch is really nothing but a female wizard. A vampire hunter is only a title assumed by a character of any class who is dedicated to the destruction and elimination of those loathsome creatures. The same is true of assassins. Killing for profit requires no special powers, only a specific reprehensible outlook. Choosing the title does not imply any special powers or abilities. The character just uses his current skills to fulfill a specific, personal set of goals. Dungeon Master's Guide, 2nd edition. Nonetheless, 2nd edition did introduce a number of additional classes and class modifications called kits. The Shaman, Runecaster, Assassin, Barbarian and Monk each were implemented many different ways, including as their own classes, though they were not included with the initial set of classes in the Player's Handbook 3rd edition. The 3rd edition abolished the practice of grouping classes directly, allowing hit dice, attack bonus, and saving throws to vary for each particular class. Again, 3rd edition also saw the return of the Monk as a base class, the creation of the new Sorcerer class, and the inclusion of Barbarian as a base Player's Handbook class, previously described in 1st edition's Unearthed Arcana rules and as an optional kit in 2nd edition's. Statistical requirements on classes and experience bonuses were abolished, though a low score in an important statistic to a class would still adversely affect a character in it. 3rd edition allows for a much more fluid idea of multi-classing than earlier editions, as one unified experience points per level table was made rather than earlier editions' rules on splitting experience. Characters can simply choose which class they wish to take a new level in and add the appropriate bonus from the class. Prestige classes were also introduced in the 3rd edition's Dungeon Master's Guide, with new classes only available at higher level and after meeting several prerequisites. In addition to the 11 classes presented in the PHB, various alternate base classes were presented in supplements, and the Dungeon Master's Guide presented 5 weaker classes designed for NPC's core character class. The 11 base classes presented in the 3rd edition Player's Handbook are: Barbarian BBN, Bard BRD, Cleric CLR, Druid DRD, Fighter FTR, Monk MNK, Paladin PAL, Ranger RGR, Rogue Raj, Sorcerer Sor, Wizard Wiz. Prestige classes. See also, list of prestige classes. Prestige classes were introduced in 3rd edition as a further means of individualizing a character. They expand upon the form of multiclassing and are inaccessible at first level, specifically meant to be multi-classed into from the base classes. To attain a specific prestige class, a character must first meet a number of prerequisites, such as certain feats or membership in a specific organization. Prestige classes offer a focus on different abilities that may be difficult to attain otherwise. For example, the 3rd edition version of the Assassin Prestige class grants minor magical powers, more sneak attack damage, and better usage of poison. 35 revision. Some of these classes were readjusted for balance in the 35 revision of the game. 4th edition core character classes. Classes in 4th edition Player's Handbook: Class Power Source Role, Cleric Divine Leader, Fighter Martial Defender, Paladin Divine Defender, Ranger Martial Striker, Rogue Martial Striker Warlock Arcane Striker Warlord Martial Leader Wizard Arcane Controller Players Handbook 2 Avenger Divine Striker Barbarian Primal Striker Bard Arcane Leader Druid Primal Controller Invoker Divine Controller Shaman Primal Leader Sorcerer Arcane Striker Warden Primal Defender Players Handbook 3 Ardent Psionic Leader Battlemind Psionic Defender Monk Psionic Striker Scion Psionic Controller Runepriest Divine Leader Seeker Primal Controller Eberron Players Guide Artificer Arcane Leader Forgotten Realms Players Guide Swordmage Arcane Defender Dragon Magazine Assassin Shadow Striker Heroes of Shadow Vampire Shadow Striker The 4th edition heavily retooled the class system in favor of a more unified set of mechanics for characters, which was in part intended to reduce some of the perceived imbalance between spellcasters and non-spellcasters in the 3rd edition classes can be defined as the combination of a character role with a power source and are differentiated by what active use class features and powers they give, all of which follow the same pattern of at will, once per encounter, once daily and utility powers. The 4th edition player's handbook does not include some classes from 3rd edition, such as the Barbarian, Bard, Druid, Monk, and Sorcerer though these classes returned in the 2nd and 3rd volumes of the Player's Handbook but does include the new Warlock and Warlord classes. 26 classes were released in total power sources. Different classes draw on different power sources for their abilities. The power sources used by the Player's Handbook classes are Arcane, Divine, and Martial. Arcane classes gain magical energy from the cosmos, Divine classes receive their power from the gods, and Martial classes draw power from training and willpower. The Player's Handbook 2 introduces the Primal Power Source, which draws power from the spirits of the natural world and features transformation as a theme. Dragon number 379 included the Assassin class, introducing the Shadow Power Source. The Player's Handbook 3 introduced the Psionic Power Source, which draws power from the Mind Player's option. Heroes of the Elemental Chaos introduced builds which use the Elemental Power Source character roles. Characters of a given class are said to fill a particular role in the party, especially in combat. Leaders are focused on buffing and healing allies. Controllers focus on affecting multiple targets at once, either damaging or debuffing them, or altering the battlefield's terrain. Defenders focus on blocking attacking enemies or drawing their attacks to themselves and are typically focused on melee combat. Strikers are focused on mobility, dealing heavy damage to single targets and avoiding attacks, while some leader and striker classes and builds are focused towards either melee or ranged combat. The roles as a whole are not paragon paths and epic destinies. The optional prestige classes from earlier editions have instead been replaced by paragon paths and epic destinies as methods of character customization. Each character may choose a paragon path upon reaching the paragon tier at level 11 and an epic destiny upon reaching the epic tier at level 21. Paragon paths are often, though not always, class specific, and some have additional prerequisites. Other paragon paths are restricted to members of a certain race or are associated with a nation or faction in a campaign setting. Paragon paths generally expand on a character's existing abilities. For example, fighter paragon paths improve a character's toughness, resilience, or damage with melee weapons. Epic destinies generally have looser prerequisites than paragon paths. Many are available to multiple classes, and some, such as Demigod and Eternal Seeker, have 21st level as their only prerequisite. Each epic destiny includes at least one way in which a character can establish a legacy and at least one way in which a character can retire. Most epic destinies provide fewer benefits than paragon paths, but the benefits that they provide are far more powerful. A common feature of an epic destiny is to allow characters to usually once per day return to life or otherwise continue to function after dying. Unlike prestige classes, a character may only take a single paragon path and a single epic destiny, and path and destiny advancement is in addition to class advancement rather than being in lieu of it. 5th edition. This section needs expansion. You can help by adding to it. September 2014 classes in 5th edition are mechanically and thematically similar to 3rd edition's version. Classes gain new abilities as they reach each level, while characters do get more powerful as they level up. There's less artificial scaling up of power levels to match equally scaled up monster power levels. Base character classes. The 4 base classes presented in the 5th edition free to download basic rules are Cleric Fighter Rogue Wizard. The base classes presented in the 5th edition Player's Handbook include the above 4 plus the following: Barbarian, Bard, Druid, Monk, Paladin, Ranger, Sorcerer, Warlock. Archetypes. The concept of Paragon Paths or Prestige classes has been dropped. Instead, each class has multiple subclasses, which allow players to choose which archetype of their class they want to follow, e.g. the Berserker Barbarian, the Evoker Wizard, the Wild Magic Sorcerer, the Beastmaster Ranger, etc. Usually chosen at an early level, this archetype defines many of the abilities that the class receives, and usually starts making itself felt on second or third level references. A.B. Fine, Gary Allen 2002, Shared Fantasy, Role-Playing Games as Social Worlds, University of Chicago Press, pp. A.B. Cook, David 1995, Players Handbook Revised Ed. TSR ISBN. General Controversies Editions, Gen Con Popular Culture Related Products, Retro Clones, RPGA Sources and Influences, Gameplay Adventures Alignment, Dungeon Master Game Mechanics, Magic Miniatures Creators, Dave Arneson, Keith Baker, Ed Greenwood, Jeff Grubb, Gary Gigax, Tracy Hickman, Robert J. Kuntz, Mike Merles, Frank Mentzer, Jim Ward, Margaret Weiss Companies, Grenadier Models, Hasbro, Judges Guild, Paizo, RAL, Partha Strategic Simulations, TSR. Wizards of the Coast Licenses, Game System License, Open Game License, System Reference Document. Greyhawk, Kara Tur, Mystara, Planescape, Ravenloft, Spelljammer Worlds, Abair, Toril, Eberron, Kryn, Mystara, Orth, Underdark, Planes of Existence, Prime Material Plane, Inner Planes, Outer Planes, Far Realm, Plane of Shadow, Cleric, Druid, Fighter, Magic User, Mage, Wizard, Monk, Mystic, Paladin, Ranger, Sorcerer, Thief, Rogue, Warlock. List of Alternative Classes Character Lists, Dragonlance, Forgotten Realms, Greyhawk, Ravenloft. Notable Characters, Drizzt Doerden, Elminster, Igwilv, Raistlin, Mahire, Mordenkainen, Lord Soth, Strahd von Zarevich, Metallic Dragon, Elementals, Fey, Fiends, Giants, Humanoids, Lycanthropes, Monstrous Humanoids, Oozes, Outsiders, Plants, Undead. Notable Beholder, Drow, Dark Elf, Githyanki, Illithid, Mind Flayer, Lich. Lists by Edition, Original Classic AD. Halfling Deities, Monster Archdevils, Demon Lords, Dragon Deities, Drow Deities, Dark Seldarine, Fey Deities, Seely Court, Giant Deities, Goblinoid Deities, Orc Deities. Lists by Setting, Dragonlance Deities, Forgotten Realms Deities, Greyhawk Deities. Player's Handbook, Dungeon Master's Guide, Monster Manual, Classic Rule Sets, Dungeons, Draconomicon, Dungeon Master Option, High Level Campaigns, Fiend Folio, Forgotten Realms Campaign Setting, Libris Mortis, Manual of the Planes, Player's Option, Combat, Living Greyhawk Journal, Polyhedron. Notable Modules, List of Eberron Modules and Sourcebooks, Against the Giants, Dead Gods, Desert of Desolation, Dragonlance Expedition to the Barrier Peaks, The Gates of Firestorm Peak, The Isle of Dread, The Keep on the Borderlands, The Lost Caverns of Soykinth, Queen of the Spiders, Ravenloft, Red Hand of Doom, The Ruins of Undermountain, The Temple of Elemental Evil.